Dear Dad, I love you. Never thought the last time I'd say hi was through FaceTime. Never thought the last time I would have eaten your sinigang or chicken crock pot was during Thanksgiving 2020. Never thought I'd have to say see you soon this year. The thing is, Dad, you've given me so many wonderful memories that will last me my whole entire life. There was never a moment where you were never there for me. When I say I was close to my dad, it wasn't just I'd hug him every time I saw him. It was a type of closeness where I was able to call him dude and joke with him. It's a type of best friend relationship where we were able to dance together. It's a type of bond that we had where I was able to cry to him when a boy broke my heart. It's a type of respect I had for him when I needed advice on school or life, and he was the first person I'd go to. It's a type of love he gave where I felt like I was the luckiest daughter in the whole wide world to have him by my side. My dad is the smartest person I've ever met. He attended one of the most prestigious universities in the Philippines with a bachelor's in economics and worked alongside his dad on his car company that made it into textbooks and the news. He definitely lived life. He traveled all around the world from Japan to Italy, naming my sister's middle name Venetia off of one of his favorite places he's been to. My dad is one of the most ambitious people I know, studying engineer to business to law. He eventually met my wonderful mother and decided to drop everything in the Philippines and come to America to start over. It wasn't easy, but if anyone can do it, he can. He went to school again while working, taking care of four kids, and graduated with a bachelor's in business management with honors. You can say I grew up with the best role model. Throughout his life, he always emphasized God and family, which meant he never missed any award ceremonies, basketball games, volleyball games, pageants, dance competitions, birthday parties, graduation, family trips, and more. Dad, you're the first man I've ever loved. When I went through breakups, my dad said to my mom, always be the man to love Jamie and never leave her. And he kept his promise. He taught me what true love is like with his relationship with my mom. 24 years together, and I've been lucky enough to see what it is like to have met your soulmate, and it's the most beautiful thing. My dad looks at my mom like she's the most beautiful person in the world. I'll miss looking behind me during vacation, seeing them hold hands and extremely happy together. I'll miss hearing them call each other love. I'll miss hearing them laugh together during breakfast downstairs, being the first ones up early. But I am thankful that my mom and my dad were able to experience real love and show that to me and my siblings. The word best friend doesn't describe how much he means to me and my siblings or how close we are to him. My brother was his bestest friend in the whole world. They did everything together, from building, cooking, hiking, camping, watching movies, playing basketball, and more. I'm glad they spent so much time together because I see the humble, kind, and intelligence from Dad in him. Throughout the Judean, they shared a sweet relationship together where my dad protected her and guided her through life. Now my Ate is capable of anything that comes her way. To Jasmine, where they were a tag team on anything, whether it was cooking or paperwork, they knew what the other was thinking. Jasmine is incredibly smart, hardworking, and a leader. I see that in her like I saw in Dad. To Ate Keeks, my dad's firstborn, and gifting him his first grandchild, Harley, made him the happiest grandpa in the world. Ate Keeks is not afraid to stick up for herself and people she loves, which is from my dad. Me, daddy's little girl, sharing a close bond with him where I never wanted to leave his side when I was home and talk to him like he was my best friend about boys or friends, or talk to him like a mentor when it came to school. I am who I am today because of you. I'm ambitious, selfless, tough, and hardworking because you taught me to be. As you raised me, I picked these traits from you, knowing these will make me the best version of me, like it was of you. You are my number one supporter when it came to any of my interests. You even took time off of work to drive me to LA for my acting jobs. You took me every weekend to my acting classes, dance classes, and to my basketball, volleyball games. You provided me constant support and encouragement when it came to school. When I finally met my purpose in life, which is helping others through medicine, you had no doubt in me to pursue one of the hardest careers. Which is why today, I know I could become one of the best doctors out there in the world. I have big plans that I was thankful enough to share with you before you went. I have plans of owning hospitals named after my very own dad. I have plans for serving the underprivileged and more. I have so much I want to give to the world, and it's because of how you raised me, Dad. You've given me the best gift anyone could, and it was believing in me until the very end. There's so much I want to say to you, Dad. So much I want to thank you for. I feel like this video or any video will never do you justice for how much you positively impacted those around you. I know we are also thankful to have you in our lives. You are finally at rest in heaven with Nanay, which I know you've missed so much. I know you didn't want to leave us this early, Dad. But you know you prepared us for anything that comes our way. You deserve more than this, but I'm at peace knowing that you're away from pain and suffering in this world, and you're in heaven with all your loved ones. You always joked and said you had a GPS in my car to see where I was, but now you're forever watching over me and the rest of our family. I love you is an understatement. There's not enough words to explain the love and gratitude I have towards you, Dad. I will live your legacy. I will tell my kids about their amazing grandpa. I'll take care of Mom and the family. Don't worry, Dad. It's gonna be okay. You know I'll miss your daily texts, calls, saying you want me home and you miss me. Now you're always gonna be with me, Dad. I'll hold you in my heart until I can hold you again in heaven. See you soon.